Hey guys, and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pachala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And this video we are going to talk about the diseases of skin. So without further ado, let's get started. Welcome back to another 5 in 5 series where we cover each topic under 5 headings in 5 minutes. And today's topic is the pemphigoid. So this is an uncommon autoimmune vesiculobullous lesion. So this is the autoimmune, as well as there are vesicles and bullous which are formed in the skin and the mucous membrane. What happens? There is subepithelial bulla that are formed in the basement membrane zone. So what happens in pemphigoid? The epithelial, it gets separated from the connective tissue. So there is a bulla or the vesicles which are formed between the epithelial and the connective tissue. Unlike the pemphigus vulgaris, like we have covered in the previous video, in that there was the split of the epithelium. In this, there is no split of the epithelium. In fact, the epithelium gets separated from the connective tissue. So before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future notifications. Talking about pemphigoid, so this is the subepithelial bulla in the basement membrane zone. What happens? This is an autoimmune disease in which our body produces autoantibodies against the basement membrane zone. So we know that hemidesmosome, which is connecting the basement membrane, which is connecting the epithelial cells to the connective tissue. So there are autoantibodies which are formed to these hemidesmosomes. So there are inflammatory cells, there is chemotactic factor. So because these inflammatory cells, they releases proteolytic enzyme, especially the proteases enzyme. So this proteases enzyme causes the destruction of the hemidesmosomal junction, and thereby the basement membrane gets separated. So there is separation of epithelial from the connective tissue, and therefore the formation of subepithelial vesicles, subepithelial bullae that are formed in case of pemphigoid. And this is how these bullae are formed. So we have two clinical variants of the pemphigoid. So that is the cicatricial pemphigoid and the bullous pemphigoid. Cicatricial pemphigoid is the pemphigoid which covers the mucous membrane. Bullous pemphigoid is the pemphigoid which covers the skin. So we have pemphigoid covering the skin and the mucous membrane, right? So cicatricial pemphigoid is the one which heals by the scar formation. So that is involving mostly the mucous membrane. So mucous membrane of the mouth, mucous membrane of the oral tissues, and mucous membrane of the eye. So oral lesions are initially, they are a slow progressive, they are mild erosion or desquamation of the gingival tissue. So we see these vesicles or bulla that are arising from the mucosal tissues, mucosal areas. Now these vesicles, they rupture to form the large painful eroded ulcer. So the patient complains of discomfort and pain, and there may be desquamative gingivitis if it is associated with the gingiva. Also we see Nikolsky sign, which we have covered in the previous video in the pemphigus vulgaris, that after the pressure there is the skin which comes out, which is seen in the mucous membrane, which is seen in the oral cavity. It is also positive in case of pemphigoid. So Nikolsky sign is positive, and there is healing up by the scar formation. Also we see the eye lesions that includes conjunctivitis, some blister formation in the eyes, corneal ulceration, and there can be a swelling. So what happens, because we know that there is a healing that is by the scar formation, so there is fibrosis and there is scarring of the lacrimal duct, which can lead to dryness of the eyes, which can lead to dry eye, and there can be scarring of the conjunctival mucosa, which can result even in the blindness. There are a rare skin lesion which occurs, then comes the bullous pemphigoid. So bullous pemphigoid includes the skin, and we know that it heals without the scarring. So there is no scar which is formed on the skin in case of bullous pemphigoid. So what happens, there is initially the vesiculation, then they rupture to form the ulcers, and finally heals without the scar formation though. So these skin lesions, they occur across all over the trunk and the limbs, and initially they are red erythematous plaques, but then they form the bullous medulla and then they rupture to form the ulcers. So what do we see in histopathological section of pemphigoid? So we see that the epithelial gets separated from the connective tissue and in between there is a vesicle which is formed. So that is called as subepithelial bulla formation, which happens, which is a characteristic feature of the pemphigoid. So there is separation of epithelium from the lamina propria. So we don't see any acantholysis, we don't see any epithelial degenerative changes, we just see that the epithelial get detached from the connective tissue and there is a split, there is a subepithelial split. We see that subepithelial bulla which is formed, subepithelial split. Now this split may contain the neutrophils also sometimes. So how do we treat it? We give the systemic steroid therapy to the patient. So this is about pemphigoid. I hope you have enjoyed the video. So if you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below and there is a link in the description box below to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I will see you soon in the next video.